Hello friends, welcome to TextStudySell. In this video, we will make a IoT based home automation project using the Blink IoT platform. As you can see, I can monitor the temperature and the relative humidity on this OLED display and the Blink app. And I can also control the AC lamp from the Blink app and this manual switch. So as you can see, it is showing me the real-time status of the switch on the Blink app. This relay module also can be controlled by sensing the room temperature and the ambient light. So if I select the auto mode, for that I have to press the C-mode button once. Right now the relay is in auto mode. You can also see the mode in the Blink app. So in the auto mode, if I cover the LDR, you can see the relay 2 turns on. And if I hold a lamp in front of the LDR, the relay 2 automatically turns off. In a similar manner, we can control the relay 1 with the DHT sensor. When the temperature will become greater than the predefined maximum temperature, relay 1 will turn on. And if the temperature is lesser than the minimum temperature, the relay 1 will be turned off. Instead of lamp, you can also connect a fan with the relay 1. Then the fan will automatically turn on if the temperature crosses the predefined maximum temperature. So this is a very useful home automation project, and during the video I will share the circuit diagram and the code I have used for this project. And after watching the complete video, you can easily design this home automation project for your home. So let's get started. These are the components required for this home automation project. I have shared all the details in the description. Now you need to connect these components as per the circuit diagram. Now as there are a lot of connections, so to give the project a professional look and make the circuit compact, I have designed the PCB for this project and ordered it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with three simple steps. First, upload the GOBA file which you have downloaded. Then change the parameter like masking color, quantity. After that, place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you can get the PCB within a week. So as you can see, you can easily order good quality PCB in affordable price from JLC PCB. Now I will place all the component on the PCB as per the circuit diagram for soldering. Now after soldering, you can see the PCB will be look like this. Now I will connect the Node MCU. Then I will connect the OLED display. You can use both 1.3 inch or 0.96 inch OLED display. So here I am connecting the 1.3 inch OLED display. After that, I will connect DHT sensor to measure the temperature and humidity. And here I will connect the LDR. So here you can see I have connected all the component on the PCB. So now we will set up the Blink app for this project. So as I have used the Blink IoT platform to control the relay module, so you have to download and install the Blink app from the Google Play Store or App Store. After that, click on Open and tap on the New Project. Here you have to select the Node MCU board, and you can also give the project name, say Smart Relay 4, and connection type should be Wi-Fi. Now I will tap on Create. Now Blink will send an authentication token to the registered mail ID, which will be required in the code. Now again I will tap on OK. Now first I will add two gauge widget to show the temperature and humidity reading. Now I will click on the first gauge widget and select the virtual pin V5, and with this widget I will show the humidity reading. So I will type here humidity, and I will select the limit 0 to 100 as it will show the relative humidity. And here I will type the percentage sign. I can also change the color, and this will be push type. So in the similar manner, I will set the widget for the temperature. I will type the temperature here, and I will select the virtual pin V6 to show the temperature, and the limit I will select 0 to 50 degrees Celsius. And here I will type the degree Celsius sign as it will show the reading in Celsius. And I will change the color of the widget.
and this will be the push type. So thus we have created two gauge with it to show the temperature and humidity reading. Now I will add three style button to control the relay module. So now I will tap on the first style button, and with this button I will change the mode. So I will select the virtual pin V3, and when we are sending 0, then it will be in manual mode. So let me type here manual mode, and when we are sending 1, then it should go to auto mode. So here I will type auto mode, and this will be switch type. And in the manual mode I will select the color blue, and in the auto mode I will select the color yellow. So thus we have created our first button. Now I'll tap on the second style button and select the virtual pin 1, which will control the relay 1, and here to turn off the relay we'll send 0, and to turn on the relay we'll send 1. So I'll not change it, and this will be switch type. And in the similar manner I'll create a second button to control the relay 2. Here I'll select V2, and this will be switch type. Now I will resize all the button for better look.
So this is the code which I have used in this project. You can download the code from my website. I have shared the link in the description. So in the code, first you can see you have to install this library. Then you can set the maximum and minimum temperature to control the relay in the auto mode. So when the temperature is greater than the maximum temperature, the relay 1 will turn on, and when the temperature will less than the minimum temperature, relay 1 will turn off. In a similar manner, relay 2 will turn off and on as per the ambient light. So we have to set this as per your requirement, and here you have to enter the authentication token sent by the Blink app. So I'll go to the registered mail ID, copy this authentication token, and I will paste it here. And here you have to type the Wi-Fi name and the password. Now if you refer the same circuit, then you can just upload the code after doing these changes. So now I will explain the code how it works. So here you can see I have defined all the pin here. And now if I go to the void setup, here you can see first we are defining the baud rate, then we are defining the display parameter. After that we are defining the input and output pin, and here you can see with this line we are calling this check physical button function after every 500 milliseconds to check the physical button status, and we are sending the sensor data after every 1 second with this send sensor function. So this line will call this send sensor function after every 1 second, and will display the data on the OLED after every 2 seconds. So the display will get refreshed after every 2 seconds. Now if we go to void loop, then in the void loop first we are checking if the CMOD button is pressed, then we are changing the mode of the relay module with this change mode function. Then we are checking the mode, so if it is in auto mode, then we are checking if the temperature is greater than the maximum temperature, then we'll turn on the relay and send the feedback to Blink app. Or if the temperature is less than the minimum temperature, then we are turning off the relay 1 and send the feedback to Blink app. And in a similar manner we are controlling the relay 2 with the LDR value. So if you refer the complete code, you can easily understand how the code works. But still if you face any problem, let me know in the comment section.
After uploading the code, I have connected these two AC lamp with the relay module as per this circuit diagram. And as you can see, I can monitor the temperature, relative humidity and the current mode of the relay module on this OLED display and the Blink app. And I can also control the relay module from the Blink app and this physical push button. And as you can see, it is showing me the current status of the switch on the Blink app. Now I will select the auto mode. For that I have to tap on this button, and as you can see in the OLED, it is now in auto mode. So in the auto mode, we can control the relay module using room temperature and ambient light. So if I cover this LDR, the relay 2 will turn on and if I hold a lamp in front of the LDR, the relay 2 will turn off, as you can see. In a similar manner, if the temperature is greater than the predefined maximum temperature, relay 1 will turn on, and if the temperature is lesser than the predefined temperature, then the relay 1 will turn off. And as I said previously, you can also use 0.96 inch OLED display for this project, as you can see. So this is a very useful home automation project. If you have internet in your smartphone, you can easily control the relay module from anywhere of the world. And if you find this project helpful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.